Today is the obligatory memorial of saint-kateri-tekakwitha, Lily of the Mohawks. Today's Mass is being offered for Carol Waters at the request of the Carol family. Here is a wise virgin from among the number of the prudent who went forth with lighted lamp to meet Christ.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who desired the Virgin Blessed Kateri-Tekakwitha to flower among Native Americans in a life of innocence, grant through her intercession that when all are gathered into your church from every nation, tribe, and tongue, they may magnify you in a single canticle of praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. In the days of Ahaz, king of Judah, son of Jotham, son of Uzziah, Rezin, king of Aram, and Pekah, king of Israel, son of Ramaliah, went out to attack Jerusalem, but they were not able to conquer it. When word came to the house of David that Aram was encamped in Ephraim, the heart of the king and the heart of the people trembled, as the trees of the forest tremble in the wind. Then the Lord said to Isaiah, "Go out to meet Ahaz, you and your son, at the end of the conduit of the upper pool, on the highway of the fuller's field, and say to him, 'Take care, you remain tranquil, and do not fear. Let not your courage fail before these two stumps of smoldering brands, because of the mischief that Aram plots against you, saying, "Let us go up and tear Judah asunder, make it our own by force, and appoint the son of Tabeel king there." Thus says the Lord, "This shall not stand, it shall not be. Damascus is the capital of Aram, and Rezin is the head of Damascus. Samaria is the capital of Ephraim, and Remaliah's son, the head of Samaria. But within 60 years and five, Ephraim shall be crushed, no longer a nation. Unless your faith is firm, you shall not be firm." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God upholds his city forever.
God upholds his city forever.
Great is the Lord and holy to be praised in the city of our God. His holy mountain, fairest of heights, is the joy of all the earth.
God upholds his city forever.
Mount Zion, the recesses of the north, is the city of the great king. God, with her castles, renowned is he as a stronghold.
God upholds his city forever.
For lo, the kings assemble, they come on together. They also see and at once are stunned, terrified, routed.
God upholds his city forever.
Quaking, sees them there, anguish like a woman in labor, as though a wind from the east was shattering ships of Tarshish.
God upholds his city forever. to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus began to reproach the towns where most of his mighty deeds had been done, since they had not repented. Woe to you, Chazarin, woe to you, Bethsaida, for if the mighty deeds done in your midst had been done in Tyre and Sidon, they would long ago have repented in sackcloth and ashes. But I tell you, it will be more tolerable for Tyre and Sidon on the day of judgment than for you. And as for you, Capernaum, will you be exalted to heaven? You will go down to the netherworld. If the mighty deed done in your midst had been done in Sodom, it would have remained until this day. But I tell you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom on the day of judgment than for you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Have you noticed in all of the readings how God's mighty acts and God's powerful word must reach all nations? You and I have received the gospel message by the people that have come before us, namely our mom and our dad. The community of believers have heard this powerful word, and it's a mighty, powerful one that resonates in our very minds and our hearts. It's a following. It's just not listening to stories of yesteryear and reminiscing. It's a way of life, isn't it? For you and me who believe, this is a powerful way of life because it's attached to our very identity. It's who we are. We follow the Creator who made all of the heavens and the earth and all of living things, and how his powerful Son has saved this world by his own death and resurrection. The gospel message is very efficacious. You and I have experienced it. You and I have heard and listened to it. You and I have accepted it. And now you and I live it. So when we listen to the gospel text and we listen to the Hebrew scriptures, in particular today from the prophet Isaiah, we understand about how powerful and potent faith is, and how God has extended this powerful and potent faith to all the world, to every nation. But someone has to be sent. Someone has to preach it. Someone has to continue the very message. But more importantly than that, a community must live it. Because the gospel is best expressed by its living out of the very words in which we hear and we preach. I think we know that, don't we? I think it's very important that we do hear it. But I think it is very important as well when we see it lived out. You know, they say that stained glass windows reflect the scriptures in color. You'll look at stained glass windows and you'll see very different images of maybe Bible texts or scenes. It's the same thing with murals. They say it's the Bible and the catechism in color. People look upon all of these images and they begin to understand really what they believe, what they have heard, what they have read. But most importantly, it's in the people that have been baptized, confirmed, and nourished by the Eucharist. You're the living word in the living church. God's living word is poured upon you and poured upon me. And because of that, by our actions will they know what we believe. Jesus has taught us that. Because he even wanted to tell the people of his day, it's so nice that you
that must be matched by the very actions of your life. Or this is really null and void in a particular way, because it's not backed up by what we believe. How our actions really dictate what we believe. Why I'm saying this is because today is the beautiful memorial of kateri-tekakwitha, the lily of the Mohawks. And I say all of this, and how beautiful the scriptures are displayed to all nations, is because the gospel must be proclaimed to every nation, tongue, and tribe, as the opening collect describes in our prayer today. How God uses you and me to bring about this powerful message. And it's like a fire that's ignited and passed on. And the beautiful light of Christ is shed upon all the world. It's to burn out evil and to give warmth to our cold hearts. Well, Kateri has done that in a beautiful way amidst people that did not know the faith. And how beautifully she has accepted it, baptized, confirmed, and received the nourishment of the Eucharist to allow her to go out and to preach this message of Christ to all the people of our own day and in our own tribe and our own tongue. Let us all do that. I think we need more kateri-tekakwithas even in this land. In this land in which the Native Americans, in which we understand, possess this land. We need to make sure that we are a people of peace and a people that really extend the message of Christ to all people by our actions and our way of life. But I tell you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom on the day of judgment than for you. Why? Because you have received this message, but you do not carry it out. Let us carry it out. I'm going to end this homily with the opening collect once again, because I just think it's powerful. O God, who desired the Virgin Blessed Kateri-tekakwitha to flower among Native Americans in a life of innocence, grant through her intercessions that when all are gathered into your church, from every nation, tribe, and tongue, they may magnify you in a single canticle of praise. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
That through the intercession of saint-kateri-tekakwitha, all members of the church may continue to grow in love of and fidelity to Christ, let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may God guide all who hold public office and all who assist them to carry out their policies, let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all nations and peoples living with the effects of war may soon experience peace and reconciliation, let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That everyone in this faith community, through our witnessing of the mighty deeds of God, may receive the grace we need to place our trust in Him, let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have gone before us in faith may live forever in God's presence, let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Patricia Cox, Doris Marsh, Pat Matthews, Justin McLaughlin, and all those on our prayer list, let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Prior Walters, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Your
also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus, like saint-kateri-tekakwitha did. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through the earth and the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed
are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Through the vine and the work of your hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember the virgin church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold, Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Behold, the bridegroom is coming. Come out to meet Christ the Lord. For those of you watching virtually, now is the time for you to make a spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already